Chapter 46. The Immortal Prince flew across the ice, hoping this wasn't the last throw of the dice. The Immortal Prince couldn't catch up with the little princess and found the portal closed. He'd come too far to turn back. All he could do was push on. Chapter 47. The princess sighed as she dipped her toes. This time she decided, it won't go up my nose. Shallow people always floundered on the surface, so Grandpa had said. You have to look deep for those who control their destiny. But they're the dangerous ones, young lady. Thank you. Chapter 48. Traversing the mountains, this must be the way, up amidst the clouds and the birds of prey. Chapter 49. The princess surveyed a barren view where the walls and floors seemed few. Grandpa had said there are always obstacles in life. Even if you can't see them, no point going where there aren't obstacles. There's nothing good to be had in those places. Chapter 50. Chapter 51. The princess longed to take flight and soar, but first she had to do a little more. Life is full of branching paths. Chapter 52. Once again on solid earth, the caverns echoed with her mirth. The little princess skipped through the cavern of the marsh muds. Chapter 52. Once again on solid earth, the caverns echoed with her mirth. The little princess skipped through the cavern of the marsh mud, squelching out of her shoes as she went. Chapter 53. Now we know even immortal blood would rather not wade through mud. At last, the immortal prince was close. The princess ran just ahead. Now, if only he could remember from what he was saving her. Chapter 54. The princess's little heart sank, again in the marsh, so slimy and dank. The princess remembered when Grandpa had taken her to an orchard, busting with chirping birds. For hours, she had watched the birds wheel and glide. Grandpa said, "You have to be fast when adventuring, like the birds. If you're not, you won't find much treasure." Chapter 56. Practice makes permanent, the saying goes, so repeat to learn through highs and lows. The princess couldn't find any magic scrolls, but as she searched, a realization dawned on her. I don't need the scrolls anymore, she thought. I know these spells. Chapter 57. Here currents run, fast and strong, so listen well to the water's song. Grandpa had always told the little princess to try to see the best in every situation. So as she was buffeted by the raging torrents, she was glad that at least the swamp mud would be washed away. Thank you. Chapter 58. Even within this fetid place, goblins sallied from an unseen base. The mud became more solid, and a little light made its way through the murk. It seemed the marshlands were coming to an end. Chapter 59. Treasure that squats out of sight is revealed by the sun's warm light. Once, Grandpa had run from goblins carrying an invisible chest. He had buried it to make good his escape. It said that nobody ever found that chest. Not even Grandpa.
Thank you.
Chapter 60. The princess wondered what still lay ahead, lurking between her and her cozy bed. The dungeon the little princess found herself in swarmed by goblins. Once again, time gave her a helping hand. The princess wondered if she'd have to repay these favors somewhere down the line. Chapter 61. Through the trees, rain pattered and dripped. For a moment, the princess's morale dipped again, the princess thought, where my adventure began.